Welcome back, dear students, for today's English class. So this is your English teacher. Today we are going to discuss two topics. First one, degrees of comparison. Already we started last week, last class. Today we are going to complete that. And then next one, supplementary, homeless man and his friends, a true story. So first, let's move on degrees of comparison. Degrees of comparison. What do you mean by degrees of comparison? Degrees means giving some quality, comparing, giving some quality. We are comparing the person or thing or place, whatever it might be. So we are giving some quality to an adjective. That is called degree. So in that, how that the adjectives are changing in degrees of comparison. So we have three terms we are using: in positive term, and comparative term, and superlative term in degrees of comparison. Okay. The first rule says add er with adjective to make comparative, and est to make superlative. This is the basic rule. So when we want to change adjective or positive into comparative, what we have to do? We have to add er for comparative, and we need to add est for superlative. That is the basic rule. Okay, let's see the example. Positive, fast. That is the adjective, fast. So in comparative, what the rule says? We have to add er, faster. Superlative, what the rule says? EST, fastest. So that is next word, tall. Positive adjective word, tall. So here comparative, taller, and the superlative, tallest, EST. Next one, small, smaller, smallest. Strong, stronger, strongest. Rich, richer, richest. Poor, poorer, poorest. This is what the first rule say. So we have to add er for comparative and est for superlative along with adjective. The first rule is over. Next we move on to the second rule. So before go to the second rule, we have to know the vowels. So you have to know that vowels. Hope you know already what are the vowels we have. How many vowel letters we have? So 5 letters. What are they? A, E, I, O, U. Okay, these are the 5 sounds in vowels. 5 letters in vowels. Remaining all consonants. Okay, so in alphabets we have 26 letters. So 5 letters are vowels. Remaining 21 letters are consonants. Okay, so now, so why we are going to see that vowels? Here the second rule say most of the one syllable adjectives comparative form adding er. So most of the one syllable. One syllable means what? For example, there is a word tall, adjective tall. In this adjective have only one syllable. So syllables, we are giving syllable based on the vowel sound. Based on the vowel sound only, we are giving syllabification. So for example, ta, a, a. So here, which vowel sound is coming here? A, a. A, E, I, O, U, the first sound, a. So there is only one sound is coming. So what the rule is say, most of the one syllable adjectives, comparative form we have to add er. Okay, so that's what. Here, tall. Here, comparative form, taller. So here, superlative form, tallest. Okay, so next one. Here, long. Long also one syllable word. Long. So what syllable, which vowel sound is dominated here? Again, la, a. Only one sound, a sound. So this also one syllable word. So if there is a one syllable word, adjectives for comparative is adding er. Okay, so long, longer, longer, and superlative as usual, EST, longest, tallest and longest. So, rule 2 is over. If that most of the one syllable adjectives comparative, we have to add ER. So, most of the one syllable words in comparative form, we are adding ER. That is the second rule, say. The third rule, when we come to the third rule, one syllable adjective ending in E, just add R. So, same, third rule also say, most one syllable adjective ends in E. For example, large, there is a adjective large. This adjective ends in E. Okay, so it ends in E. So what we have to do when we want to change comparative? So just add R, not ER. The previous rules and all say add ER, but this the rule third say, rule 3 say, one syllable adjective ending in E, what we have to do? Just add R. Large, larger, largest. Because already E is here. Already E is here. You just want to need R. That is the third rule. Large, larger, largest. Here wide. Wide is this adjective ends in E. E no. So what we have to do? Merely add R. Because already E is here. He comes here. Okay. So no need to add ER again. Already E is here. So merely want to add R. Wider and widest as usual. And that, let's move to the rule 4. Last three letters of the words. So consonant, vowel, consonant. If you take a adjective word, positive adjective word, that word has this pattern. Consonant, vowel, consonant pattern. So if you take adjective word, that word has this pattern. For example, consonant, vowel, consonant. For example, B is consonant, no? I is vowel. Again, G is consonant. So, last three letters of the adjective have this pattern, consonant, vowel, consonant pattern. What we have to do? We have to double the last letter. So, what is the last letter? G. So, in comparative, we have to double the letter. Big, here bigger. We are doubling that G, that's what. Okay. So, bigger. So, superlative, biggest. There is no change. Here, hot. So, first letter consonant, second letter vowel, and the third letter T is again consonant. Consonant, vowel, consonant pattern is there means. So what we have to do? We have to double the last letter. Hot. So what is the last letter? T. H-O-T-T-E-R, hotter. So superlative, no change, hottest. Okay. So the rule 5th. Next we move to the rule 5. So, adjectives ending in Y, change Y to an I. So, what is the rule 5th say? The adjective ends in Y. For example, happy. So, this adjective ends in Y. So, what is the rule say? You have to change Y into I. So, in comparative, H-A-P-P, this Y will be changed into I. Happier. Okay. And happiest. In superlative, happiest. Understood? Okay. The next letter. Pretty. So, adjective ends in Y. What we have to do? Change this Y into I. Happy. Here. Instead of Y, in comparative, happier. I we have to add. And then superlative, prettiest. Okay. So, hope you understood. Still, we have two more rules that we are going to see now. Dear students, I already told you, if the one syllable word, so how we are changed? If the adjective ends in one syllable, we just add R along with the adjective. So, the next rule says two syllable word. two syllable word. For example, here beautiful, so two syllable or more than two syllable, three syllables or four syllables, okay, two syllables words and more than two syllables, two syllable and more than two syllables, okay, wow. So that's one, more than. More than two syllables, how the adjective is changed in comparative and superlative. For example, we have this adjective word beautiful. So how many syllables are there based on the vowel? Beautiful. Here O, E, U. So three syllables are there. So how it will be changed in comparative form? So is there any idea? Yes. So in comparative form, two or more syllables in comparative form, you have to add a small word before the adjective. More beautiful. And superlative, most beautiful. Superlative, most beautiful. Understood? So two or more syllables in adjective, in comparative form we have to add more, and superlative form we have to add most. That's it. So next, important. Important. So how many syllables are there? Im, po, a, a sound, tent, a. So three syllables are there. So what will be the comparative form? More important. More important. And the superlative form? Most important. Most important. Understood, dear children? So how they are changing? Two syllables and more than two syllables. So next, we have some exceptional cases in adjectives. So how they are changing in comparative and superlative. So we are going to see that some exceptional. Okay. The exceptional case. Exceptional case. How they are changing. For example, positive good. Positive or adjective? Both are same only. Positive only called as adjective. Okay. So adjective form only called as positive. They are given. So good. So what is the comparative form? Gooder? No. So not gooder. This is the exceptional case. Good, better. Okay. Good, better. And superlative form? Best. Okay. So this exceptional case is totally different from that rules. Okay. So positive one form, comparative another form, and superlative some another form. Okay. Good. Positive good, comparative better, and superlative best. Next one, bad. Bad. So comparative form, worse. Superlative form, worst. Understood? So third one, little. Little. So comparative, less. Superlative, least. Understood. Likewise, these some of the exceptional words will be changed. Okay. So much for this is a very much many in comparative positive, much many in comparative more. Comparative more, superlative most. So these are the changes, forms of different forms of degrees of comparison. So how they are changing in positive, how they are changing in comparative and superlative degree based on the rules. Hope you understand. Next we move to that the supplementary story, homeless man and his friends, a true story. Please take page number 122. Page number 122. Dear students, in this lesson, we have three characters. First one, homeless man. Homeless man and his friends. This is the title. This is the true story. This is not a fictional story. This is the true story we are going to see. Okay, so first character, Caesar. So in this story, first important character name is Caesar. Caesar. Second, Chris Mamprim. Chris Mamprim. So Caesar is the hero of the story. Here Chris Mamprim is a nurse. And the Dodo. So Dodo is the assistant. Assistant of Chris Mamprim. And the dogs. And then fourth, dogs. Yeah. Now we move to the story. Okay. There is a homeless man in Rio do Sul in South Brazil. So the South Brazil, there is a man. His name is Caesar. Rio do Sul. He in Brazil, there is a place called Rio do Sul. Okay. In that place, there was a man. He don't have any home. Okay. Homeless man. Okay. So who often sacrifices his own food to feed the stray dogs around him. Whenever he don't have any home, any possessions, any assets, so he lived in the street. Okay, like a beggar. Okay, homeless man, like a beggar, very very poor man. So what we will do if we see that poor man in the street? So what you will do? So you will give some almsgiving, we will give some money or food. Okay, we will help them as much as we can. We will help them. Likewise, whenever that man get food from others, so what he did, he just sacrifice his food and give to the stray dogs. So this already is a poor man. So when he get food from others, he didn't eat. So what he did, he took only a small quantity of the food. Sometimes he didn't eat the food. So he just fully give to the, sacrifice his food means, he just fully give to the stray dogs. Okay. So dogs around him, were lived around him, it was very attached with him. So he gave the whole food to the four dogs around him. That's what. One time he suddenly required emergency treatment, his kindness came back to him like a boomerang. So here, boomerang. So boomerang means nothing but, that is a curved stick. When you throw means it will come back. That is called boomerang. Okay. So a curved stick, when you throw means, once again it will come back to you. So One time he suddenly required emergency treatment. His kindness back to him like a boomerang. So he was kind. He was show kindness to the dogs. No. Once he got he required emergency treatment. He was not well. So all his kindness, all his whatever the kindness he showed to that others, the dogs, it was come back to him like a boomerang. Okay. That's what. For the faithful dogs he had been feeding made sure he was not alone. So who replied the kindness to that homeless man? The dogs, the faithful dogs. Okay, that's what he's saying. The dog's incredible loyalty was witnessed by nurse Chris Mamprin and her colleagues. The homeless man known as Caesar. That homeless man name is Caesar. By nurse Chris Mamprin and her colleagues, the homeless man known as Caesar arrived at the emergency room of the hospital at about 3 a.m. to seek treatment and medication for a pre-existing health condition he had been battling. It was his first time at the hospital for treatment. As he normally goes to another health facility in town, this Mamprin and her colleagues did not know about Caesar's condition nor his background. Okay, as I already told you, this man came to the hospital for treatment. Okay, the dogs, the incredible dogs, the dogs, what they did, were witnessed by the nurse Chris Mamprin and her colleagues. So when he was come to the hospital at early morning 3 a.m. So early morning 3 a.m. he came to the hospital for treatment. So that nurse witnessed that the four dogs, he was show kindness to the four dogs, no, sacrifice his food to the four dogs, no, the four dogs also came along with him to the hospital. So who saw that? That nurse Chris Mamprin. The Chris Mamprin saw all these things. Okay. So the four dogs came along with this man and they were waiting in the reception for this master, for their master. Okay. So he had been battling. So he was in a suffering. So he came to the hospital and the four dogs also came along with him. It was his first time at the hospital for treatment. So this is the first time he came to this hospital. Okay. First time he came to this hospital. Previous times he would go another hospital. That was the first time he came to the Chris Mamprin hospital, the hospital where Chris Mamprin worked. Okay. So she was the nurse. Chris Mamprin was the nurse, worked in that hospital. She looked at surprisingly. So a man came to the hospital. So there was no relatives, there was no friends who came along with him, but only four dogs came along with this man, and the four dogs were waiting for the man in the reception, the hospital's door. Okay. So she was should look all those things in a very surprising manner. So on that, so because it was his first time to this hospital, Chris Mamprin and others, they didn't know about this man Caesar. Okay. Because if he would come previous time, means they can remember him, they may remember him, and they know about his background, who is this person, his relatives, who are his friends, they came to know. But it was the first time for Caesar to go, went to that hospital. So they didn't know about the man and his background. Okay. So they just saw the four dogs and the Caesar. Okay. Thus Mamprin and her colleagues did not know about the Caesar condition nor his background. They did not know about the Caesar condition and his background. How he suffered. So how he got suffered. So what is the problem he got? So why he came for treatment? They do not know. They didn't know. So what is the problem? Okay. See, they didn't know. That's what. But not before long, they realized that he had a gang of dogs accompanying him. So I already told you. So gang of dogs accompanying him. So four concerned dogs had showed up at the entrance of the hospital. So how many dogs? Four concerned dogs. Concerned dogs, very kind dogs. They were waiting for his Caesar in the hospital. entrance of the hospital and were waiting for Caesar. They were concerned about their homeless master, who the nurses soon learned had been for some time forgoing his own meals to feed the dogs. Okay, these nurses, soon they come to know that, okay, so this man Caesar, he didn't have any relatives or friends. His relatives and friends, only the four dogs. The four dogs only came along with him. So, this man might sacrifice his food to these four dogs. That is the reason for his suffer. That is the reason for his treatment. That is the reason for his not a physical problem. Okay. So, whenever he get the food, he just sacrifices to the dogs. So, his body got weak. Okay. So, that's what he came to the hospital for treatment. These nurses and others, they came to know this would be the matter. So, he might sacrifice all the foods to the four dogs. So, that was the reason for his weakness. That was the reason for his weakness. Sick. So, they came to know that. Okay. Ma'am Prem snapped a photo of the touching scene and later posted in the Facebook saying. So, this is not a ordinary thing. So, this is the some surprising, extraordinary thing. So, a man came to the hospital, but four dogs also came along with him and they were waiting for his homeless master. Besides, that man was not a rich man. He was a homeless man, very poor man. But those dogs were waiting for his homeless master in the entrance of the hospital. So, Miss Chris Mamprim, she just take a snap and she posted in the Facebook. All these things, what was happened in that hospital, she took a snap and posted in the Facebook and writes like. So, this is the statement she posted in the Facebook. I came across this today at the hospital where I work. So, Chris Mamprim, she just share his experience. What has happened today's morning, share his experience and she give the message in the Facebook. So, at the hospital where I work, at 3 a.m., while their master who lives on the street, so here master is Caesar, he's a man who is living in the street, was being treated. He was came for treatment because of sickness. Okay. His companions waited at the door. Who are the companions? The four dogs. His companions were patiently waited at the door. A simple person without luxury. Without luxury means what? He's a very poor man. He doesn't have any assets. He doesn't have any luxuries. Luxurious means any things, possessions. So, he's a very poor and simple man. For that simple man, the four dogs were waiting. Okay. Who depends on help to overcome the hunger, the cold, the pain, the evils of the world, has by his side the best companions and the exchanges reciprocal. So, what are the things for possession of this man? Okay. What are the things he had? What are the possessions he had in his life? The cold, the pain, the evils of the world, the hunger. So, those things only were the companions of this, the poor man. What? Hunger, cold, pain and all the evils of the world. Which means, he didn't have any possessions, he didn't have any assets, he didn't live a luxurious life. Instead of, he had only hunger, pain, sick, all the difficulties he experienced in his life. Such a poor man. Okay, so that's what these all the difficulties only were his companions for that Caesar. Okay, so by his side the best companions. So these difficulties were the best companions for Caesar and the exchanges reciprocal. Okay, these were living along with him. These difficulties were, he was living along with all the difficulties of this world, all the evils of the world, all the difficulties suffers of this world. An exchange of love, affection, warmth and understanding. A person who confesses to us that He stops eating to feed them, Ma'am Prim continued. So Ma'am Prim say, next, what he says, an exchange of love, affection, warmth and understanding, a person who confesses to us that he stops eating to feed them, Ma'am Prim continued. So what that Caesar told him, he stopped eating in order to an exchange of love, affection with the four dogs. So in order to give exchange of love, affection, warmth and understanding, that Caesar, whenever he get food, he just sacrificed all his food and gave to the dogs. Okay, so that's what. So he didn't experience any goodness in his life. So he experienced, he lived all the suffers, but in that difficult condition, situation, whenever he get the food, so in order to show his love, understanding, affection to the animals, he gave to them. So he stopped eating. So that is the reason for his sickness. So Miss Chris Ma'am Prim continued. So speaking to the dodo, so the Chris Ma'am Prim, he just told all this events, what has happened to the dodo. Dodo is a person. So the assistant of Chris Ma'am Prim was another person. So to the dodo, Chris Ma'am Prim told this story. So what has happened in the hospital. Okay. Speaking to the dodo, Ma'am Prim said, they are all well taken care of Chubby. So who are all well taken care of Chubby? Those four dogs. So when they look upon the four dogs, they were very chubby. They were very healthy. Why? What is the reason? Because of Caesar's sacrifice. Whenever he got food, he just gave to the dogs. He was very lean. He was very weak. He was sick. But those dogs were very healthy. Okay, very chubby. So that was the reason Chris Ma'am Prim told. The faithful canines were anxiously anticipating Caesar's safe return. Okay, fortunately, the animals reunited with their owner in no time. So the faithful canines, the faithful dogs. Okay, so the faithful dogs were anxiously anticipating Caesar's safe return. They were very anxiously means very worried. They were worried and they were waiting in the entrance of the hospital for their master. Okay, they are expecting their master's arrival. He got treatment inside the hospital. The four dogs were expecting his master's arrival. His master, good health. Okay, so he was. They were waiting, very anticipating. Anticipating means expecting. Okay, worriedly. Okay, that's what. Fortunately, the animals reunited with their owner in no time. So once again, they were reunited with the owner. Caesar got treatment and came. Not wanting to keep Caesar and his companion support, the staff led the dogs inside after giving him the medication and he needed. They even offered some food to Caesar. Believe me, he had some and saved a bit to give the dogs later, Ma'am Prim called. So the treatment was going on inside for Caesar. The nurses and others, they were given treatment to the Caesar inside. But after all the treatments is finished, what they did? They never let the dogs sitting alone. They just let the dogs come inside to see his master. Okay, after the treatment is over, they just let the dogs to come inside and see his master. That's what given. They even offered after that, what is the reason for that Caesar's sickness? Because he didn't eat food for a long time. So whenever he get the food, he gave to the dogs. So that was the main reason. So in that hospital, after the treatment, given the treatment, so what they did? They gave some food to the Caesar. Even in that place, what Caesar did? He ate only small quantity of food. Okay, so just small food, small amount of food only he took. The remaining food, once again, what he did? He gave to the four dogs in the hospital itself. So such a beautiful and amazing incident was happened once again in the hospital. Already he was in a sick condition. He was in a weak condition. But once again, he took only small amount of food and he gave remaining food to the dogs. Okay. So by seeing that, Chris Ma'am Prim become very shocked and surprised. Such a man he was. Such a kind man he was. Okay. She was thinking like that. An hour later, Caesar left the hospital with the four dogs. So treatment is over, everything was over. So Caesar, he came back from the hospital with the four dogs. So the four dogs trailing behind. So it was going behind the Caesar, happily wagging their tails. The four dogs, they become very happy because his master, he got good health now. So, okay, so they were coming along, they were going along with this master with a happy, wagging his tails. Wagging his tail means just shaking his tails and go behind his master with a happy mood. I do not know that last concluded that Chris Mamprim conclude this paragraph. I do not know what is his life is like. I do not know why his life is like this. Or why he is on the street? Why he is on the street? I do not know why his life is like this. But I admire the respect and love he has for his little friends. But the Chris Mamprim conclude that I admire. I do not know why this man is in the street. So what is the problem? Why his relatives forsaken him, abandoned him? Okay, I do not know. But I respect his kindness. So his love for the little. For his little friends, which means the little friends means the dogs. Okay, Mamprim concluded, seeing them like this waiting at the door just shows how much they are well cared for and loved. So when I see the dogs were waiting for this Caesar, I came to know that how much love and affection he showed to those dogs. Okay, so that same love and affection came to him like a boomerang. That's what. Even though Caesar has little material possessions and likely has no kin to turn to be, he is never alone because he has his warm and loving companions. No, so that last what she says, even the Caesar, he didn't have any friends and relatives to go back, but he is not a lonely person. He is the person. So what he say? He is never alone because he is a warm and loving companions. He always a warm and loving companion. He is not a lonely person. Okay, he is not a lonely person. He always having loving companions. Okay, that's what he say. So he is a warm and loving companions because of the dogs. So he is the not a single man. He is not alone. He is not alone hereafter. Always he is having loving and caring companion. That was who are that? That four dogs. So my dear children, so like Caesar, you also start to love the animals around you. So that is the moral of this story. Thank you. Next class, till we meet the next class, signing off. This is your English teacher. Thank you.